All right, guys, welcome back to a great segment. We are going to give you updates about this Mario Draghi, known as the Prime Minister of Italy. You know, this man have kind of like getting the support from different party, which will make him to be the Prime Minister of Italy officially. Now, this man have come as to kind of like give some updates about Italians, and as well, there are some articles that relates to with the immigrants in the country. I think it's going to be based on article everything. So you are going to kind of like have patience and watch this video to the end so that you see what this man are planning towards immigration. I told you guys that, you know, Matteo Salvini does not kind of like have any good mind for immigrants, but I found out some people were trying to rejoice that, you know, Matteo Salvini is trying to change towards immigrants. Matteo Salvini is not changing anything. Rather, it's getting worse every day. In this particular video, you get to know, because I'm going to give you all the evidence which you need to know. Without wasting time, let's kick in together and see how it look like. Alright guys, so here we are to read the article so that you guys can see what this Mario Draghi is planning for the Italians and that of the immigration part of it, you understand. So you are going to listen carefully because everything here is going to be based on article, and then later we'll try to give you some video to watch about Matteo Salvini, what he's saying, and then we'll give the explanation and then round up the video. Alright, he said here, Prime Minister Mario Draghi urged Italians to pull together in a historic effort to rebuild their country. Comparing the task ahead to post-war reconstruction as he sets out an ambitious, firmly pro-European agenda for his new government. You understand? He said, today we have the possibility, or rather the responsibility, to start a new reconstruction as governments did after World War II. The former head of the European Central Bank told Roman senators in the first details presentation of his administration program. You understand? He said, the newly installed prime minister, credited with saving the euro in 2012, centered his speech around European integration ahead of the confidence vote in the upper house on Wednesday evening. He says to win thanks to a big majority. So now this man known as Mario Draghi have won the big majority on Wednesday on the upper house, you understand, from the parliament. But have it in mind, even this evening, Thursday, there is still going to be an election which they are going to still hold on this Mario Draghi. Though all these things are just to kind of like confirm him and satisfy him to be the prime minister. Normally, he's going to get the election as well, because all the parties are with him. They're just trying to kind of like follow the due processes which is needed for him to be confirmed as the prime minister. But normally, he's going to get the vote and everything, because all the parties are supporting this man to become the prime minister. So there is no opposition like that, apart from the Giorgia Meloni, who don't kind of like cannot stop all these things. Now let's go a little bit forward so that you guys can see how all these things are playing. All right, he said here, on Wednesday evening, he said to win thanks a big majority, like I said before. He said senators are due to vote about 11 p.m. while lower house lawmaker will vote Thursday evening, like I said. All right, he said here, we must be proud of Italy's contribution to the growth and development of European Union, Draghi said. Without Italy, there is no Europe. The prime says national state will remain the reference for citizens, but they will have to concede national sovereignty to gain a shared sovereignty. So now let's go to the part where you guys are expecting, because there are many articles that this man are saying many things about Italians. I think at the end of the topic, I'll try to summarize everything by explaining to you guys so that you guys can still see how all these things are going. But first, we are going to watch the video of Matteo Salvini after this part. All right, he said here, on an immigration, a crucial theme for Matteo Salvini's league, Draghi backed in remark on Wednesday evening a long-standing proposal by Italy along with several Mediterranean partners, including Spain and Greece, for an obligatory mechanism of pre-quote redistribution of migrants within the EU, which he called a solidarity measure. So you understand? So what they are trying to explain here is that Mario Draghi is saying that, you know, Italy will not only be the country to kind of like take the responsibility of immigrants, that, you know, other countries known as the European countries, talking about Germany, talking about France, talking about Austria, talking about other European countries, they have to come together to coalesce in order to redistribute immigrants to fulfill the path which they are being saying, you understand? So this is what this man known as Mario Draghi is still insisting that other European countries have to follow on to the solidarities, which state that they have to distribute immigrants who will be arriving in Italy to other parts of the European country. Now, let's watch the video of Matteo Salvini, where he's trying to kind of like say many things. And then when we come back, I will explain all the things to you guys so that you guys can see how all these things is going.
Presidente, noi ci siamo, la Lega c'è convintamente. Non vediamo il senatore Ciampolillo, ma tanto ha tempo per arrivare in aula prima del fischio finale. E già è cambiato il mondo, eh? Rispetto alla compravendita dei senatori di un mese fa, già è cambiato il mondo. E questo è già un suo primo storico merito, aver riportato serietà in quest'aula, e per questo la ringraziamo. Noi abbiamo fatto una scelta di coraggio, di lealtà, di amore per il Paese. Abbiamo scelto l'Italia, abbiamo messo il bene dell'Italia prima dell'interesse di partito. Questo per noi significa davvero prima gli italiani, mettere la salute e il lavoro dei nostri genitori e dei nostri figli prima degli interessi, dei litigi o delle beghe di partito. Il suo governo, che è convinta da parte mia e della Lega, da parte del primo partito di questo Paese, significa dare più forza all'Italia in Europa. Se l'Europa garantisce salute e lavoro, evviva l'Europa. Se l'Europa impone disoccupazione e chiusure e sbaglia a ordinare i vaccini, criticarla e cambiarla non è un diritto, ma è un dovere di ogni cittadino di questo Paese. Lavoro. Abbiamo accolto con gioia l'impegno a non mettere nuove tasse, no alla patrimoniale, no all'aumento dell'IMU, no al prelievo sulla casa o sui conti correnti, no a nuove tasse e un taglio progressivo dell'IRPEF. La Lega è una forza politica concreta, noi non ci attacchiamo alle sigle o alle etichette. Se questo governo si impegna a non aumentare le tasse esistenti e a tagliare progressivamente le tasse su imprese e famiglie, per noi sarà il primo grande successo di questo governo. E su questo benessere e del lavoro, non per l'Europa delle chiacchiere che lasciamo a qualcun altro. L'Europa per noi è difendere gli agricoltori e i pescatori italiani. La scelta è fra cibo naturale e cibo artificiale. Noi siamo per la dieta mediterranea e i prodotti della nostra terra. L'Europa. E io ringrazio il presidente Draghi che ne ha parlato sia stamattina che stasera. L'Europa ci chiede di difendere i confini italiani che sono confini europei. E per la Lega sentire dal presidente Draghi parlare di un cambio di passo in Europa e di rimpatri ed espulsioni per gli irregolari è qualcosa che ci riempie di gioia e di orgoglio. E su questo ci avrà al suo fianco.
Guys, I hope you have heard what this man known as Matteo Salvini is saying. Alright, what I want you guys to understand in this particular point is that, first of all, this Matteo Salvini is stating that, you know, the rate at which Italians are paying tax have to be reduced. This is the first thing this Matteo Salvini is asking to Mario Draghi, and then which Mario Draghi is trying to adopt on these things, because this Salvini supported Mario Draghi in order for him to be a kind of like appointed as one of the ministers, but as God may have it, the man did not give him any of the position. Now he's trying to kind of like advise this man, telling him what to do. I told you guys that this man don't have any good plan or any good agenda for we the immigrants in this country. For that reason, you should know that there is no way this man can love immigrant. There is no way. Be you regular or not regular, there is no way Matteo Salvini can love immigrant, because you already have that passion of hatred towards immigrants, so there is nothing that can change it. Now, where I want you guys to understand is the part where is very critical. Most people don't understand, because himself did not put the word in a direct form, but he's putting it indirectly. But let me bring it out direct to you guys so that you can understand. this Salvini is trying to kind of like give speech to this man known as Mario Draghi in such a way that people who are not a kind of like a regular in Italy, they have to be taken back to their home country of origin. Well, this is not the first time Matteo Salvini tried to kind of like make this kind of speech, you understand, but let's be seeing how things are going, because, you know, Italy cannot just come out and then deport people like that. But if it happens to be, maybe they try to mean it with European, other European countries, I think the possibility to do that kind of thing will be a kind of like 90% or 80%. But let's see how things are going, because this government, Matteo Salvini, is trying to kind of like pull more efforts, kind of like to stop immigration. I told you guys time without number. This is what this man is always talking about. Because if you come to see it now, Matteo Salvini will say, okay, now let's debate this issue. Matteo Salvini will say, okay, fine, now we have to use the law of European, other European country to face the one here in Italy, using the law of France, Germany, Austria, and different kind of places. If you're talking about this law, there may be the good aspect of it. At the same time, there might still be the bad aspect of it. Let's, for example, Germany that do deport people, and then Italy kind of like adopt this law, which Germany do deport people even overnight without knowing. Then it's a bad effect. Then talking about it, kind of like the way other countries take care of immigrants, that aspect, Salvini will never put those ones into consideration. Talking about to go and take the law from other European countries, if himself we kind of like take the bad aspect of it and then come and impose it here in Italy, this is what this man is thinking of. So trying to advise Mario Draghi that those ones who are not regular in Italy should be taken back to their country of origin, this is the plan Matteo Salvini is having. So for you, he's happy that, you know, Matteo Salvini have changed. This is the change you are seeing on Matteo Salvini. On this government, only God will help us on this government. You know, there is something that we do say that here is not our country. On a very good day, we have to go back to our country, because if the leaders try to set the place in a conducive place, I don't think anyone will be coming here to kind of like receive insult from these white people or all those kind of stuff. So guys, this is the update I have for you. If you have any question based on this argument, because if we continue like this, we try to debate, because now tomorrow might come, Draghi will bring up any idea based on immigration. So we have to update you guys and be seeing how all these things are going. If you have not subscribed to this platform, please try to subscribe. The next time again, we'll be together.